What's in the other side of a black hole? To be fair, you would still be crushed. The exact fate of matter sucked into a black hole has long been the subject of debate, but the general view is that it would all be compressed into one point in space, the singularity. A rear exit would provide a place for matter to go instead of being completely smashed. It's a wild idea, but wormhole theory has taken weird turns before. The basic principle is that a black hole's gravity is so strong that it bends space-time itself. Envision the universe as a sheet of paper. If some force folds part of that paper, then two non-continuous pieces of the paper touch. If an object on one part of the sheet crosses over the fold, when the sheet straightens out, that object finds itself still on the paper, but distant from its starting point. Now consider that the piece of paper contains both space and time. If both ends of the wormhole are close together, then in theory, a traveler might end up at a different point in time. The wormhole, for obvious reasons, is a staple of science fiction. But it's a pretty well-established idea in actual science, too. Einstein's wormholes are often described as linking different universes rather than different parts of the same universe. Continuing the sheet of paper analogy, imagine that a strong force pulls together two points, each on two different sheets of paper. An object at the connection point could therefore cross from one piece of paper to another, as in, cross into a completely separate universe. Combining the concepts, it might even be possible to wind up back in time in a different universe. Unfortunately, the new research, while providing more theoretical insight into the structure of black holes, does not put interstellar travel within reach. Even if black holes are permanently open, wormholes as postulated, it still is not possible for anything to cross intact without being crushed. Matter falling into the black hole would be split out the other side, but not in the same condition it went in. And the gravity is so great that any wormhole would not stay open longer than an instant. Still, there's no real way to know for sure without trying it. The resulting uninhabitable black hole would have such a powerful gravitational pull that not even light could avoid it. So, should you then find yourself at the event horizon, the point at which light and matter can only pass inward, as proposed by the German astronomer Karl Schwarzschild, there is no escape. According to Massey, tidal forces would reduce your body into strands of atoms, or spaghettification, as it is also known, and the object would eventually end up crushed at the singularity. The idea that you could pop out somewhere, perhaps at the other side, seems utterly fantastical. Indeed, Thorne, who lent his expert advice to the production team for the Hollywood movie Interstellar, wrote, "We see no objects in our universe that could become wormholes as they age," in his book, The Science of Interstellar. Thorne told Space.com that journeys through these theoretical tunnels would most likely remain science fiction, and there's certainly no firm evidence that a black hole could allow for such a passage. The name black hole seems to have created something of a misunderstanding, and the images that show the gravitational well of a black hole don't seem to hold either. From all the correspondence I get, I know many imagine these objects as magnificent portals to some other world or dimension, that they might be getaways, which will take you off to adventures with beautiful, glistening people in oddly tailored chainmail cod pieces and bikinis. So, if you were to jump into a black hole, where would you come out? What's on the other side? Where do they take you to? Black holes don't actually go anywhere. There isn't an actual hole involved at all. There are massive black orbs in space with an incomprehensible gravitational field. We're familiar with things that are black in color, like asphalt, or your favorite Cure shirt from the Wish tour that you've only ever hand-washed. Black holes aren't that sort of black. They are black because even light, the fastest thing in the universe, has given up trying to escape their immense gravity. Let's aim for a little context. Consider this. Imagine carrying an elephant around on your shoulders. Better yet, imagine wearing an entire elephant, like a suit. Now, let's get off the couch and go for a walk. This is what it would feel like if the gravity on Earth increased by a factor of 50. If we were to increase the force of gravity around your couch up to a level near the weakest possible black hole, it would be billions of times stronger than you would experience stuck under your elephant suit. And so, if you jumped into a black hole, riding your space dragon, wearing Maximus power gauntlets of punchiness, and wielding some sort of ridiculous light-based melee weapon, you would then be instantly transformed by those terrible tidal forces unraveling your body into just streams of atoms. And then your mass would be added to the black hole. Just so we're clear on this, you don't go anywhere. You just get added to the black hole. It's like wondering about the magical place you go if you jump into a trash compactor. As time distorts near the event horizon of a black hole, the outside universe would watch you descend towards it more and more slowly. In theory, from their perspective, it would take an infinite amount of time for you to become a part of the black hole. Even photons reflecting off your newly shaped body would be stretched out to the point that you would become redder and redder, and eventually just fade away. Light follows a straight line through space-time, even when space-time has been distorted into the maw of a black hole. When you get inside the black hole's event horizon, all paths lead directly to the singularity, even if you're a photon of light moving directly away from it. It sounds just awful. The best news is that, from your perspective, it's a quick and painful death for you and your space dragon. So, if you had any plans to travel into a black hole, I urge you to reconsider. This isn't a way to quickly travel to another spot in the universe, or transcend to a higher form of consciousness. There's nothing on the other side, just disassembly and death. Black holes are so dense that light cannot escape from them, and they are difficult to detect. Satellites above the Earth's atmosphere can detect bursts of high-energy radiation given off by black holes. Dozens of stellar black holes have already been detected in the Milky Way, where there may be tens of millions more. We think of stars as being like our sun, one star of 150 billion in the Milky Way, which is one galaxy of hundreds of billions that fill the universe. Large stars burn their hydrogen fuel faster than sun-like stars, and as the fuel supply runs low, gravity begins squeezing their cores, starting new reactions in successively deeper shells. As an iron core grows beyond a maximum limit, the core collapses and a shockwave rips the outer layers away in a supernova explosion. At the core, gravity becomes so strong that light cannot escape. Gravity is the warp in space-time caused by massive objects, described by equations developed by Albert Einstein. But how warped can space-time get? In an extreme case, a red giant star with a million times the mass of Earth collapses into a space 1 million times smaller than the Earth. Entering the warped space, you find the pull of gravity becoming stronger and stronger as you get nearer to the mass concentration at the center. Finally, you reach the point of no return, the event horizon. Another type of black hole exists near the center of most galaxies, the supermassive black hole around which the galaxy's stars revolve. One of the biggest is a 4 million solar mass black hole at the center of the large galaxy M87. Where do these supermassive galaxies come from? To find out, the events surrounding the birth of the universe in a Big Bang were modeled in supercomputer simulations. The model tells us that a few hundred million years after the Big Bang, the gases of the cooling universe began to be drawn together by gravity. Clouds grew and heated at their cores, forming the first massive stars. These stars died in a supernova explosions that litter the early universe with large black holes. A space probe named Swift looks across space and back in time to see these early stars flaring in supernova explosions. The black holes grew larger, swallowing stars and clouds of gas as they migrated to the centers of their young galaxies. Others grew as galaxies merged, and the black holes at their cores combined into larger black holes. Astronomers have searched for the black hole at the core of the Milky Way galaxy. We are located about two-thirds of the way from the center to the outer edge of the Milky Way. Stars and clouds of dust and gas hide the core from our vision, but instruments can detect radiation that we cannot see. As you get closer to the center of the Milky Way, the density of stars increases in an area called the central bulge. Closer to the center are gas remnants of past supernovas and swirling clouds of gas. Very close to the center, stars whiz around an unseen mass. Using computer simulations, we can see what it would be like to enter the black hole. Surrounding the black hole is a disk of gas falling toward the center. But the inward falling gas collides with itself, and a large part of it is pushed away, forming jets racing outward. Nearing the event horizon, the point beyond which anything that crosses cannot escape, space is warped, and it becomes like a lens. Falling below the event horizon, we see a storm of energy and matter continuing to fall towards the center of the black hole, where there exists a point called a singularity, or a point of infinite density. An eye at the center of the storm may be an entrance to a wormhole, a passage for matter that emerges from a white hole at the other end. A white hole may be a gateway into another universe. That black holes even exist has only recently been proven. Everything we know about them come by our observations of them, of course. The closest black hole to us exists at the center of the Milky Way galaxy, but we cannot see it. Too much matter between us and it. Everything we know about black holes exists in pure theory. A black hole is an enigma because it destroys the laws of physics. That is, once you pass the event horizon, space and time become mishappen before they disappear altogether where a singularity exists. What happens to matter when it reaches the singularity is unknown. Some scientists believe the bottom of a black hole is a doorway to another dimension. Some think to another universe, but of course, no one knows, nor will anyone ever likely know, because we simply cannot get close enough to figure these things out. It is believed that the black hole is a massive trash can. Most of what goes in gets destroyed. Our basic understanding and laws of physics are broken by what is black holes. There is nothing on the other side as far as we know. As said, everything is theoretical. We really have no idea what a black hole does other than it has a massive gravitational pull and is the cause of our galaxy's swirl. As for it taking you somewhere, you may be thinking of the theorized wormholes, which are a lot different. If you haven't already did it, leave a like for the algorithm, drop a line below, and let us know what you think.